Hey guys, welcome back. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can create a VNet in the Azure portal. So I've already logged into the Azure portal, and before you can create a VNet, you must create a resource group. So for this demo, I've already created a resource group called Resource Group 1, and I'm going to place my new VNet in this resource group. All right, I will now create a VNet. So in the Azure homepage, I will either type virtual networks in the search box and select that, or if the shortcut is already cached in the homepage, you can select that as well. I will select virtual network shortcut, and it will take me to the virtual network window, and you can click create or create virtual network. I will click on create. It will open up a create virtual network window, and under the basics tab, I will select my pay-as-you-go subscription, specify a resource group. I will select resource group 1, specify a name for the VNet. I will type VNet 1, specify an Azure region. I will select East US, and I will click next IP addresses. Now under the IP address tab, you need to specify an internal IPv4 address for the VNet in the CIDR format. This IP address space for the VNet needs to be unique within your subscription and any other networks that you connect to within Azure on-premises network or any cross-cloud networks. There's already a default IPv4 address space, which is 10.0.0/16, and it can provide up to 65,536 IP addresses. The idea behind using a big subnet for your VNet is that you can divide that into smaller IP subnets. For example, I can create this VNet with IPv4 address space of 10.0.0/16 and divide that into multiple subnets. Let's say I create a /24 subnet called subnet 1 with the address range of 10.0.0/24 and another subnet called subnet 2 with the address range of 10.0.1.0/24, which is what we are going to talk about next. But you can also add additional IPv4 address space to your VNet. For example, I can add another IPv4 address space, let's say 192.168.0.0/16, and divide that into multiple IP subnets. I'm going to delete this. I can also create a VNet that is a dual stack, meaning it supports both IPv6 address space as well as IPv4 address space. I can do that by simply selecting the checkbox for add IPv6 address space and specifying the IPv6 address space. For this demo, I'm not going to add any IPv6 address space to this VNet, so I'm going to unselect this checkbox. Like I mentioned before, within the IPv4 address space of your VNet, you need to create your different IP subnets. For example, you can see here, there's already a default subnet called default with the subnet address range of 10.0.0.0/24, and it can provide IP address space from 10.0.0.4 to 10.0.0.254. The other IP addresses in this subnet are reserved by Azure Platform. They are 10.0.0.0, which is used for network address, 10.0.0.1, which is reserved by Azure for the default gateway, 10.0.0.2 and 10.0.0.3 are reserved to map the Azure DNS IPs to the IP address space of the subnet. And then you have 10.0.0.255, which is used for network broadcast address. You can also rename the default subnet from default to something else by clicking on it. I will change the name to subnet 1. And I'm okay with the subnet address range, which is 10.0.0.0/24, which is again within the IPv4 address space of our VNet. So I'm going to click on save to save the changes. And if you need to delete a subnet, you simply select the subnet and click on remove subnet. I will now create another subnet called subnet 2 by clicking add subnet. In the blade add subnet, I will specify the name of the new subnet as subnet 2. For the subnet address range, I will type 10.0.1.0/24 as the IP address range for subnet 2, as it is within the IP address space of our VNet 1. If you would like to provide internet or outbound connectivity to the virtual machines or the Azure resources that will be connected to this subnet, then you can specify a NAT gateway for this subnet. Since I have no NAT gateway configured, I will skip this. And if you would like to allow traffic to specific Azure resources from this subnet, such as Azure SQL or any other Azure services, then you can select these service endpoints. I'm not going to do that for now, so I will skip this. And I'm going to click on Add to add the new subnet. So now we have two subnets within this VNet. By the way, the routing between subnets will depend on the default routes, or you can define custom routes if required. I will click on Next Security. Under the Security tab, you can enable security features like Bastion Host, DDoS Protection Standard, and Firewall. Bastion Host is a PaaS service that is provisioned inside your virtual network. It provides a secure and seamless RDP or SSH connectivity within the Azure portal to your virtual machines using a web browser. When you connect via a Bastion host, your virtual machine do not need a public IP address for you to connect from outside networks such as the internet, or use a traditional RDP or SSH tools to connect to your virtual machines from a private network. DDoS Protection Standard is a paid service that offers enhanced DDoS mitigation capabilities via adaptive tuning, attack notification, and telemetry data to protect against the impacts of a DDoS attack for all protected resources within this virtual network. But a basic DDoS protection is integrated into the Azure platform by default and at no additional cost. Azure Firewall is a managed cloud-based network security service that protects your Azure resources. I'm not going to select any of these for this demo. I will simply click on Next Tags. Under the Tags tab, specify a name or value pair for tagging the resource. I'm not going to specify any name value pair for this demo. So I'll simply click on Next, Review plus Create. Under Review plus Create, ensure that the validation has passed. After reviewing your selections, click on Create to create your new VNet. Now wait for a few minutes for the deployment to complete. All right, you can see the deployment has succeeded. Now let me go back to the home page and back on the virtual networks page. Our new virtual network VNet 1 is listed here. I will click on my virtual network VNet 1 and click on address space under settings, and it will list all the IPv4 address space of this virtual network. In my case, there's only one IPv4 address space. I'll click on subnets under settings, and it will list all the subnets created for this virtual network. In my case, there are two subnets created at the time of VNet creation. All right, this concludes the step-by-step instructions on how to create a virtual network or a VNet using Azure Portal. I hope you enjoyed this video. For more videos like these, please subscribe to my channel.